Namaskar and welcome to this episode of Raga Pariche. We visit Rag Jai Jai Vanti this week. Many months ago, I think we looked at Rag Des and said that Des finds its origins in the folklore of India, and the melody of Des is deeply ingrained in the cultural fabric of India. Now there are some beautiful variants of Des, you know, the rags which very distinctly show the Des anga. One of them is Jai Jai Vanti. So we look at Jai Jai Vanti today, and we will take the reference of Des to see where Jai Jai Vanti becomes different from Des. So let's start looking at the structure of the rag. So if we remember Des was what Jai Jai Vanti does is, it just adds a note in the Purvang. So the Des Purvanga, Jai Jai Vanti adds the Komal Gandhar to this, and that Komal Gandhar is used very typically. This one change gives a completely different character to the rag, you know. But again, it's not only this change, you know, but so many other subtle changes in the chalan, in the accents, in the use of the swara. So let's go on to look at how these changes happen. The re starts becoming much and much prominent, and it is used in a very typical manner. Or now this part is almost like this, it is like this, but then the pa and the re connection. Pa re ga re sa ni sa ga ni pa re re ga re sa, very very typical of Jai Jai Vanti. And then when you start going up from the sa, the re starts taking another dimension. It always comes with the touch of the tivra or the shuddha gandha. Re re ga ma ga re ni sa, re ga ma ga re ga re sa. So if you start noticing the gandhar, the komal gandhar, does not have an existence of its own at all. You know, it is always used in conjunction with the Shuddha Gandhar and the Shuddha Rishab. So it is always used in a sandwiched, it is always sandwiched between the two. Re ga ma pa ma ga re ga re sa ga re sa, and the ga Komal Gandhar always brings you to the sa. Ga re sa ni sa da ni pa re re, re ga ma pa ma ma ga re ga re sa, and then the onset into the uttaranga is like this. But then this took off from the Rishab. It always took Rema Pani Sa. This one, since you are using the Shuddha Gandhar in the ascent, then the ascent takes on from the Shuddha Gandhar. So this is the Uttaranga of Jayajayavanti. And then for developing, you would almost take the Des roots. The Dhamma connection also is used sometimes. So essentially, the structure of this with an addition of Komal Gandhar, but a wonderful connection between the Shuddha Rishab, Pancham. This is what makes Jayajayavanti different from this. And it is, you can make out that it's a very different rag by itself. Now when you look at this structure more closely, you will notice this is the essence of the rag. And then you start noticing that this is because the complementary phrasing. Nidapa magare gare sa, nidapa re re ni sa. This essentially is the structure of the rag, you know. And when you understand the rag in this manner, with its phrasing, with its complementary pairing of phrases, then it becomes very, very easy to go on developing the rag. Now let's go on to listen to one very popular bandish in Jayajayavanti in Teen Taal. So this was the beautiful Jai Jayavanti. Now this is the Jai Jayavanti of Desh Anga. So is there another Jai Jayavanti? Yes, there is another Jai Jayavanti, the Jai Jayavanti of Bageshri Anga. It's essentially a similar rag like Jai Jayavanti, but instead of going the Desh route in the Uttaranga, it follows the Bageshri phrasing. I think we will look at the Bageshri Anga Jai Jayavanti in some other episode, some other time. Next week we move on to another very sweet, very melodious rag of the Desh family, rag Tilakkamodha.